Hello. Welcome to Stream Time. I have taken the liberty of setting up the emulator before starting the stream, so you won't have the big mess I was dealing with beforehand, like with the last stream. So hopefully this should all go well. Also, you shouldn't get that weird issue with the cutscenes anymore, where they kept sort of YouTube pooping and having these weird like audio issues and going out of sync. And I'll explain more about how I've managed to fix it, because I didn't actually do anything. But hopefully this should all be good. So I will stop playing that music. Bear with me a second. Right, I've also taken the liberty of setting up a brand new thingamajig for yes, so hang on. I've taken the liberty of making up a new stream layout. Here it is. Ta-da! I hope you like it. it's just a border, really. I've made some stream alerts too, but we'll see what happens if you even get to that. Alright.
Two.
So I am emulating this, but let's see the attract mode, I suppose, before we get started. We can skip this. This is a demo.
Time crisis. Two.
The Twitch TOS may not like the cunt part. Okay. I mean, I can usually swear like a sailor on here. Like, is there some specific word about... specific thing about the word cunt? Oh, look at the split screen mode. You ever tried this? It fucking sucked. The game runs at half speed. Or half frame rate. And you had to, like, share the screen. Well, just in case it is a problem, maybe I should cover it up. I will cover it up with something else then. How do I do it?
Two.
I don't know. I didn't want to take a risk of like getting banned. Successfully completed. Okay, well here's the movie.
Consisting of 64 satellites. The project is named Starline Network. This is a monumental achievement. Hey, Mike. Starline will unite the world.
I don't think so. The Starline Network is a mere front for a plan to launch a nuclear satellite into space.
VSSE. Who would have thought there'd be a secret plan? The launch.
Keith Martin. Robert Baxter.
There's some news.
Christy Ryan.
Wild dog.
It's almost ready. My dream will soon come true.
Ernesto Diaz.
This is actually a pretty cool intro. At least it's not when it's actually running at proper speed.
Time crisis. Two.
Your project is going down in flames. They'll be here soon.
Okay, well, let me just adjust the microphone a bit.
Time crisis. Two.
So I have managed to fix the if you were in for the last stream, I did play a bit of Time Crisis 2. I did have a bit of an issue with the emulator because it wasn't playing the that movie properly. And I've managed to fix it You know how I've managed to fix it? I'm playing the PAL version of the game. I'm using the European version. One second. And I'm actually running this off the disk that I have from my computer on the emulator, because that's a thing you can do apparently. So that apparently fixes the issue. The game seems to run better. It might be because it's running at 50 hertz instead of 60. But I don't know if that makes a difference. But yeah, that's the reason why the movies are playing properly now. There is a slight issue. I don't know if it's the emulator or this specific game, but I have found there is a very slight input delay when you press the trigger. So shots come out slightly slower than I'd like. But, you know, I've worked around it. I've actually finished this game. I've done a complete playthrough, so let's do another one. That's all it takes to blow up those searchlights, I guess.
It's me, Christy. I found some data about the satellite network. Haven't the agents left yet?
Keith and Robert are on their way. No one can beat them.
Keith and Robert?
She says that with like a slight worry. It's like, oh no, not those guys.
Well, it appears we have a guest.
You came into my room. This is,
like,
you're the guest.
Just in time. A leak like this would have been problematic. To say the least.
A punch like that and you think you're gonna conquer the world.
Silence! You have no idea how perfect our plan is. Now take her away. What the?
The plan to just launch a big satellite. Okay, here we go.
Action! Reload.
So anyway, I just started blasting. You do sort of rack up a score bonus by like consecutive hits. I think I'm just gonna focus on like staying alive, I think. Or trying to. The moment I say something like that, I lose a health, so. I tried getting Time Crisis. Ah! I tried getting Time Crisis 3 to work as well. For some reason, it doesn't emulate quite as well. It might be another thing where I had to like try out different versions of the game to see how they work. But the version I tried, which was my version running off a disc, didn't quite work properly. I have the light gun. Yes, I'm using a Sinden light gun, which is the PC light gun. I'm using an emulator. I'm not using like a CRT TV. I'd like to use a CRT TV. That's like still the best way of doing it, but I just don't have one at the moment. If I did have one, I probably don't have the space in my house for one, which is the other problem. The other thing I'm missing, I guess, is a pedal. I'm using the buttons on the gun to, like, come in and out of cover. If I wanted to recreate the true arcade experience. Of course, if you had this on PS2, I don't know if anyone else did this. Did anyone else ever use the PS2 controller on the floor and step at it with their foot? And just press the buttons with their sock or whatever? Because that also works as a pedal. If you use the controller, put it next to your foot, and use the light gun, that's sort of as close, like a very bootleg way of recreating the arcade experience. Ah! Man. I used to be good at this game, you know? I'm just out of practice. Well, I could still maybe make it. Let's see if I can... I was gonna say, like, let's see if I can do it in a single credit clear, but that's clearly not happening if I've already lost two lives at this point in the game.
Reload.
Whoops. 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 Good thing I don't lose health for that. I just lose points, which is just as bad. My high score! Again, yeah, I still have the GunCon too. I just don't have a TV to use it with. Yeah, I'm using the Sinden light gun right now! I don't know if you can hear the clicking through the microphone of my trigger. Again, the emulator's not perfect, there are a few issues with it. Like, you notice the frame rate drops a little bit if I aim to the edge of the screen for some reason. I was trying to keep that combo marker out of going up.
So, who are those two? Where's the girl?
They took her to General Diaz, sir.
We gotta stop them now!
Yes, sir.
Oh boy. So what? I don't really know, like, the briefcase didn't really seem to have anything except for, like, proof that they're building the satellite. I mean, this seems like pretty good proof that they, I don't know. Didn't seem like you need a briefcase necessarily to figure that out. If that has this location of the satellite, maybe, I guess, but... Keep shooting the guy in the back, stop it. This is a cool sequence though, I've always liked this bit. This is like one of those moments that blew me away when I got a PS2, because you know, you... Like those water reflections look super realistic, man. I think this is one of the earlier PS2 games to come out, wasn't it? Also, they did zazz up the graphics on the arcade version a lot as well. The arcade version, I think it used the same board as Time Crisis 1. So it's similar graphics of that. But here they actually upped the graphics when they ported it to consoles. Last hit! There we go. That took too long. Oh, look at those hats there.
I knew it. These maniacs have got the military satellite. And they're moving it by train.
We better get going. There's no time to lose.
I think some of these cutscenes are new for the PS2 version as well. Some of these weren't in the arcade version.
That fool Yakov! How dare he fail! Hurry it up!
Yes, sir. look over there.
Let's go!
Beep, beep, motherfuckers! See, I'm using the PAL version of the game. That does mean the game's running at 50Hz instead of 60. So it's 50 frames per second. Usually that means the game runs a bit slower, but it seems like they've corrected the speed for this game. So it runs the speed it's supposed to, it's just at the lower frame rate. Way close. Gotcha. Oh, here's the ninjas throwing their knives. Powerful machine guns we have.
Action. Reload.
Aye, I'll dodge that. I knew that was coming. Maybe I should just turn this into an endurance stream where I don't stop until I clear it in one credit clear without getting a game over. But then we'll probably be here all night. Son of a bitch. So I swear sometimes it's just luck, because some of those red shots are just random, so it's, yeah, like that. You just have to be really quick at reacting to it. How many credits is that so far? Two? Why would the blue guy fire the red shot?
Action! Danger! Danger!
I thought. I didn't think he'd fire three red shots. This isn't going very well. This is going better than the last time I did this. 27 minutes of ads, really?
Nice try, boys. But my job's to protect this satellite. It's time for you to say goodbye.
Alright. Sometimes, in some ways, the bosses are like easier than the rest of the game because you can kind of predict them to a degree. Okay, sure. Imagine being hit on the head with a warhead. You know, I feel like you're doing better with the gun. It's hard to know when he's actually going to shoot this guy. There we go. Missile's just a really large bullet. I guess that's one way of looking at it. Yeah, I think the bosses are kind of easier than the rest of the actual game. Because you can predict the bosses. Enemy is just like, oh, surprise, bullet.
Did you get him?
It's our helicopter now! Haha!
My dream is just about complete! And the world will be mine.
Your project is going down in flames. They'll be here soon.
I'm expecting them. Why do you think I kept you alive?
General Diaz, we've got trouble.
So soon? Wild Dog, it's time.
Yes, sir.
We're good. Fell out of a helicopter, we're fine. The close quarters fighting here. I always forget about that yellow guy. Hello, welcome to the chat. Yeah. Damn it.
Reload. Action.
Watch out for Wild Dog.
So much time to get rid of them. All right, I'll take care of this myself.
Action!
So I shot you in the face, it's fine. Yeah, again, in some ways I feel like the normal enemies are harder than the bosses, because I can kind of predict what Wild Dog's doing. Everyone else is just surprise bullets. Eat shit, Wild Dog! Yes, I'm playing with the Sinden light gun.
SSE, you fools.
That line is burned into my brain. I don't know why.
VSSE, you fools.
Action.
Yeah. And some of these, like, so close. Damn it. I'm getting careless as what's happening. I'm trying to get the cool headshots. Well, I somehow managed to shoot him while he's behind the woman. I think the hitbox for him is quite lenient. Compared to, like, hitting her. Son of a bitch.
I'm okay. Get Diaz. He's about to launch a nuclear satellite.
See, I don't really know about this whole nuclear satellite thing.
This is just a prototype. We're ready to launch the real one.
This is getting out of hand. No, there are two of them.
Estimated your persistence. This is not a real satellite. Anyway, let me entertain you.
Yeah, like, I don't know. It seems like his plan is to launch this satellite that can launch nukes or something. It seems like he already has a pretty good system going, because he set up a network of like 64 satellites to create a global network. That seems to me more valuable these days than a nuke. That's like control of information. That's like these days, that's like what everyone's after, right? I guess like attaching a bunch of guns to a satellite doesn't hurt either. Getting a haircut. Ow, damn it. Damn, why did I stand on the satellite? Oh, we did it, we saved the day. And that's it. It's quite a short game, actually. That's the... I mean, it kind of feels like we stopped that rocket by accident, really, because if it wasn't for us blowing up the satellite, or blowing up him on top of the satellite, and having it crash onto the rocket, it seems like the launch still would have gone ahead. Well, I guess that's just how the VSSE operates. Hooray, we did it. We saved the day. How's that compared to the last score I got? See, this game's not going to censor me. New bullet type is available in arcade, number of credits, whatever. So yeah, you get new stuff if you keep playing it. You do also get extra stuff that was in this home console version of the game, which is like a training thing. Oh, I didn't beat my last record. About 1,500 points off. If I didn't shoot my teammate so many times, I probably would have gotten the high score. Time crisis. Well, I might as well show off the other mode, which is like training mode. So these are like basically very hard missions. Crisis mission. Right, so let's look at the backstory. I don't know why they bother putting a backstory. It's just like training missions. Neodyne Industries' launching of a nuclear satellite armed with a nuclear warhead was prevented by a hairbreadth thanks to the efforts of the VSSE agents. Dealing in the arms industry behind closed doors, Neodyne Industries put a great deal of effort into the launch of their military satellite. However, following the incident, the Marine base, which was used for their satellite development, was placed under VSSE jurisdiction. The sensitive data and equipment were confiscated, and the scientists were taken into custody. No report was heard regarding the existence of nuclear military satellite. It's going too fast. Officially announced public as a blah, blah, blah. On 1 month had passed since the incident, Keith at Wave on a Break was contacted by a single message. It was an order for VSSE agents to board simple. Alarmed by the unexpected military strength of the enemy in the recent VSSE decided it is necessary to conduct training egg drills to improve the combat skills of agents. Exercises were devised. For exercises, it was decided that special shells would be used or ammunition and the VSSE officers would simulate the enemy. The agents participating were not informed of any further details. And that's it. Alright, so, yeah, they're just missions. I'll do this one. The rest of them are actually quite hard. They usually involve, like, things like limited bullets, only one life, things like that. So, quite difficult. I wanted to emulate Time Crisis 3 because that has the side missions with Alicia Winston, which have very weird cutscenes in it. But I couldn't get that to emulate properly, so that's in the maybe pile if I can maybe get that working. So this is just shoot the dudes, but with one health. I think most of the missions have one health, actually. I already failed. So you get to watch me do this for the next hour or two. Action. Yeah. Son of a bitch. I was ready for him as well. This is the first mission. Although, having said that, you only unlock this once you beat the main game, so I guess they expect you to be proficient at the game somewhat before tackling this. And it just comes down to memorizing, really. Did it. Alright, well, that's a fairly straightforward mission. Next mission. Defeat all 26 enemies, don't hit the civilians. How hard could it be? Did mission 3, I didn't want to defeat enemy with one shot. Well, let's try this actually. Don't hit civilian. Defeat enemy with one shot. Okay, I have 4 seconds to beat this. Here we go.
Action!
Was that it? Okay, I thought that was going to be a bit harder than that. Defeat all 19 enemies, 28 seconds. Time Crisis was a game that I played a lot as a kid. I really gotta be quick on the reaction. Okay, fine. I see how it is. Trying to get good like quick shots, but it requires being good at the game. Jeez Louise. You like if you don't shoot them quick, they'll fire off those red shots. The bonus enemy. Yeah, I miss the arcades as well. They had some great stuff. Alright. What's the next mission? Defeat all 33 enemies. Okay. Yeah, I think this and House of the Dead 2 were my favourite ones. House of the Dead 2 might be an idea for a stream at some point. Action! Well, I guess this is a good way of like creating more content by reusing all the old level assets. Yeah. Seems like I have to be quite quick with this one too. Can you play Team Fortress 2 with a light gun? You know? It's... no. Essentially, I wouldn't. I was gonna make some joke like, yeah, maybe if you, you know, if you strap your gun to a certain way and configure the meta now. I tried playing, I imagine you could probably do like a very bootleg version of TF2 in VR. Because you can do like a Half-Life 2 in VR. In fact, I did that once with an Oculus, an old Oculus, like way back when like Oculus was new. But we did I tried out Half-Life 2 and it was the most disorienting thing in the world. Because I was in VR goggles, but I was still using mouse and keyboard. Yeah. So, you know, obviously the movement was a bit weird. Not only that, you know those little like camera drones in the start of City 17? Uh-oh. I would have run out of time anyway. Okay, this one's quite hard, I guess. Action. You have to be, like, really quick with this one, too, I think. Fuck me. Yeah, as I was saying, like, those camera drones in VR were like, they blind you. So the entire vision goes white in VR, it's very disorientating. I guess that's how it'd be in real life too, though. If you go into City 17, you see those flying camera drones and they just snap pictures of you with the flash. Immersive, I guess. Oh, I managed to finally do that one. On to the next one. Day 2. Oh god, day 2. Defeat all 31 enemies. I don't know how many of these missions are going to do. Action. Action. That was fucking close. I almost shot him. I was actually aiming for him. I was like, wait. Good thing my aim was shit, I guess. Ironic. I was so focused on saving them that I couldn't save myself. Action. I did it again! Son of a bitch! Action. So, earlier today I was sort of like figuring, dicking around with my like Action. Twitch layout and stuff. As you can see, I've got a new like layout or whatever. If you guys have any suggestions for possible like emotes and stuff I could make, feel free to suggest them, because I don't know what the fuck I'm supposed to put. Aside from like drawings of Slippy. I know, I said it again. Alright. Next mission. Slippy Jam. What will that be? I'll get at least that many points. Score attack. Alright, see you later. Alright, how do I do? Oh god.
Action! Reload!
Okay, the flame effects are kind of like slightly affecting the performance. Slippy Among Us? I don't even play Among Us, why would I make an emote about that? I guess it's just a hip thing at the moment. Amogus. Sussy bucker.
Reload. Reload.
It's been the hot meme for like 2 years. When's it gonna stop? It's like that meme of the guy saying stop talking about Among Us. I'm tired of hearing it. My friends on TikTok send me memes. My friends on Discord send me memes. I was in a server, right? And all the channels were about Slippy.
Action.
Okay, yeah, this one seems quite hard. Barrier mode? What happened to barrier mode? I don't know how you can like transcribe that into a very small picture to be displayed in a chat window.
Action.
I mean, I guess I could just draw more Slippy faces, but man, I don't know. Slippy's not it. I don't know. I'll think about it. I guess I could do maybe a Time Crisis one.
Action.
Reload thing. Jeez. It's always like I've said this before, it's like an anus clenching experience when you just dodge a bullet!
Action. Reload.
Shit.
Reload.
Not clenching fast enough. Guess we're gonna be here for a while.
Action.
I think just have to be quick, really. Get them before they can shoot me. Easier said than done, obviously, but... Motherfucker, I swear I shot you.
Action.
I was playing Virtual Cop yesterday, actually. Actually, I could play a Confidential Mission, because that's basically Virtua Cop. That uses the exact same scoring system and like the circle indicator to know where you, like, when enemies are gonna attack. It's even got the same Justice Shot thing, where if you shoot the gun away, you get more points. so I could play that on time. I've got a few light guns, I guess, in the... Yeah, happened again! I guess I could look at Lethal Enforcers. That's the FMV one, right? With the really shitty acting, or am I thinking of something else?
Action!
I guess I could also play games like Mad Dog McCree. Although you can just get that on the Wii nowadays as well. Nice!
Action!
Okay, so I will have to look into more light gun games, I suppose. I mean, I'm just playing the ones that I grew up with, really. The ones that I actually really liked and saw in the arcades and that were cool. I do have the PS2 version of Virtual Cop Elite Edition, which has Virtual Cop 1 and 2 on the disc. But I can also just emulate them on the Model 2 emulator, which actually seems to work pretty well, so I'll just play it on that instead.
Reload.
It's a Jurassic Park, like, I think there's a couple of... Well, actually, there's quite a few Jurassic Park arcade games. There's... The old one, I guess, is like the one of the user sprites. God damn, okay, god, fuck. The one that uses, like the old one where you're in a Jeep, yeah. I think they're all in the Jeep, but there's like there's a 2D one and then there's a 3D one. And there's one that's I've seen recently where you sit inside... You sit inside like a cabinet. Like I can still play that now. Like I've seen a machine of it at the local like seaside that I live near, and it's like a big thing you sit in with a mounted gun. It's just called, yeah, I don't know. they're all called Jurassic Park, which doesn't help. They're all different versions, but they're all called Jurassic Park. But yeah, there's a new one, there's an old one, and there's an older one.
What,
he fired that off screen. What? God damn.
Action. Reload.
No, you don't. Oh my god. Am I supposed to keep shooting him until... So I didn't even get enough points. You know what, fuck this, I'm doing the next mission. Defeat all 18 enemies. In 24 seconds.
Action!
Ooh, now it's dark. I guess this is an interesting take on it though, fighting in the dark. Okay, clearly there are enemies I couldn't see.
Action!
Thank you. guess I just have to be faster. God damn, they really... There's like no margin of error for these missions.
Action!
Like you basically have to speed run it, which I'm not gonna do here. One more try.
Action. Reload.
So close.
Action. Reload.
I didn't see him. Like, you literally... I feel like, yeah, you just had to memorize where they're coming from because you can't really see them until they pop out. That way I just cheat and turn my brightness up, but... Wait... Yeah, this mode is on the console only. You didn't play this in the arcade. Got him! Fuck me. Like, you have to be exact for that mission. Defeat enemy with one shot. Oh boy, here we go. Time for sniper mode. One shot, one kill.
Action.
Are you fucking kidding me? You fucking kidding me?
Action. Action.
I mean, if I was going for the hostage, that was a pretty good shot, but... All you had to do was follow the down train, CJ.
Action.
Okay, I'm getting closer to the hostage than I am the guy. Alright, maybe I just need to... Action. I think I'm firing too early, maybe. Well, that was too late. Oh, God. This is, you're just going to be watching this for the next 30 minutes. Oh, I got him! Sweet! Shoot the driver. Yeah, that's a much better idea, actually. I'll just shoot the wheel and see if that just derails the whole train. Get at least... Oh, no. The score attack one was the one I couldn't do last time. Get at least 18,000 points, so I guess I just gotta, like, aim for headshots and triple shot him and whatever. Yeah, I'm sure the hostage will be fine on the speeding train by himself. He'll be, don't worry. Alright.
Action! Reload.
That's not what I wanted.
Action!
Reload! Wait. I saw a green guy up there. I didn't get him though. There! I'm nowhere near the high score, what the hell?
Action.
You have to get the green guys, you have to, because they're worth 5,000 points. But it's just knowing where they're coming up, and they're only on screen for like 5 seconds. Or like less than that, like a second.
Action.
See, the green guy appears when the red guys show up, so you can't just stick out an aim for them.
Action.
Hi. Man.
Action.
God damn.
Action. Reload.
Oh my god. It's just a wall of bullets at that point. I think I got. Hang on. Let me try this again. God damn.
Action.
Didn't get the grip. Man, let's do something else. I think you only have to like, yeah, I think you can't do the next day, can you? Let's try. Let's try that first mission with the fire area again. I think you have to beat 4 missions before you can progress to the next day, because it's like several days of this. I think it's 4 days. Are they training officers on Neo? I guess that's... Well, actually, it's funny you say that, because Time Crisis 5 features the teleportation mechanic, doesn't it? It's where you have 2 pedals. Oh. Time Crisis 5 has like the 2 pedal system where you can teleport from 2 different hiding spots. So maybe that's like the training for that, where they become like basically superhuman Dragon Ball people and can instant translocate.
Reload.
Oh my god.
Action.
Yeah. Man. It ain't easy.
Action.
I'll probably stop the stream soon actually, because I can only play so many light gun games before my arm starts to hurt. And I've been playing for a while now.
Action.
bitch. A couple more tries and I'll probably call it a day then. It ain't happening. Okay, another try. Yes, it's the T-Virus, as in T as in Time Crisis! I've heard, actually, that is, speaking of Resident Evil, there is another game. There's a, was it Resident Evil Dead Aim? Apparently that, you can get that working with this light gun. That might be worth looking into. Because that's the one of the Resident Evil games I never got to play. The knife! So yeah, I don't know. If I can get Resident Evil Dead Aim, or was it? Is it Dead Aim? There's another one. There's like two Resident Evil light gun games. There's a sequel. Gun Survivor, maybe. But apparently you can get that working quite well. And if I can get that working, that might be worth the stream. Yeah! You know what, I'm just gonna stop. My arm hurts now, I've been shooting gun too much. But yeah, I mean, you know. Time Crisis, pretty fun. Actually, wait. Before I close off the stream, I guess I might as well show off. Well, there's one thing I can't show off. There's an arcade game that's included in this thing. And it just doesn't work. Because it asks me to aim the gun away and it just doesn't work. But I can show off the training mode, I suppose. Can I emulate Wii Resident Evil light gun games? Yes, I can. In fact, I don't even need to emulate those. I have those on the Wii and I can just capture that. So I can just record the light gun games. I can record Resident Evil Darkside Chronicles. Resident Evil Umbrella Chronicles isn't that interesting in my opinion. Darkside Chronicles is a bit more interesting because it's sort of a prequel to Resident Evil 4. Time Crisis, more like Arthritis. Yeah, I can't do Quick and Crash. What can I? What can I do? One of these doesn't work. And I don't know why it doesn't. Oh, it's just, I guess it doesn't detect the emulated gun properly. Oh, maybe this doesn't work. This one does work. Okay. Got him. Four. Oops. Oh. See, this is much more humane than like the real version. Think of all those clay pigeons we're not killing. I was hoping for them to cross over, but they didn't. I just missed entirely. Got him! That's it, that's the whole game. Extra version, oh boy. Intermediate course. Let's try expert, let's see how hard expert could be. Ah, yeah, funky beats. could have been cool. Beep. I knew someone who took up clay pigeon shooting once after they retired as a hobby. They said they spend like, they said they spend like £8,000 a month on a new gun, like just buying new hunting rifles. I'm like, why do you need to do that so much? And I guess he just likes to collect them. But like, goddamn. Didn't do too well that time. Right. I guess the other thing I can show off is... I can show off the training mode, which is just a very, very basic shooting range. You know, I've been on a firing range. When I went to America several years ago, I went to Arizona and I went to a firing range and fired a gun. That's very interesting. Why does it say interesting? It's fun. It's good.
Shoot. All shots fired.
I even got to keep the little piece of paper that I shot with the little markings on it. I don't know how common that kind of stuff is in America, but... They wouldn't let you on the shooting range in Texas. I mean, I did have to fill out a big form with my passport and everything for, like, safety reasons. They wouldn't just let me. It wasn't like I just went in there and said, hey, can I just shoot some guns? And they're like, yeah, sure, buddy. They actually made me fill out a bunch of paperwork before I could even touch a gun. And I presume that's kind of standard. I'm assuming there's lots of safety precautions in place.
Game over.
But yeah, that's all there is to this mode. Let's try slightly harder.
Shoot. All shots fired.
I mean, I only got to fire a handgun too. It wasn't like they let me onto the semi-automatic shit. As fun as that would have been.
Shoot.
Guess that's an okay score.
Enter your name. Game over.
Okay, that's basically it. There's one other game mode that I could show off, but again, it doesn't work for whatever reason. Like, I'll show you what happens when I try to do it. I'm guessing it's like an emulation issue with the light gun, but like Prick and Crash is an arcade game, I think. It's like that shoot away thing I was playing just now, but yeah, I can't really show it off because... I mean, maybe there is a good way to get it working, but I couldn't figure it out. Because to start off...
Let's start the game. Keep an eye on your aim and do your best. Level 1.
Yeah, I can't get past the screen. Like, I'm aiming all over the place, and nothing happens. All you just get is this fucking siren blasting at you all the time. I'm pointing away! Stop yelling at me! And you can't even quit out of the screen, either. I just had to quit, I guess. So, yeah. Anyway, that's it for this stream. Thanks for turning up. And, I don't know.
At Neodyne Industries,
yeah,
we
hope
have
you enjoyed watching me blast away in Time Crisis.
Global network consisting
just
of
got here, did we defeat Wild Dog? Yes, I beat the arcade mode, and then I spent a while,
Starline network. This
you know,
is a
doing some incredibly hard bonus Starline missions. So I guess it was a, you know, all things considered, got a lot of stuff done. there's not like there's much content in these games. They try to pad it out with all the extra content. Like, I'm presuming that's the reason why those extra missions are so hard, is so you spend ages on them and make it feel like you've got your, you know, bang for your buck. Because if it was just arcade mode, it's over in like 20 minutes. I mean, I guess I could challenge myself to do it in like a single credit clear like I did with Time Crisis 3.
There's some news.
But that's probably not stream material. That'll just be me playing the arcade mode like 800 times in a row until I finally beat it. But yeah, anyway. Whatever. I'll see you guys next time when I don't know what I'll play next. Come true, Ernesto Diaz. So, as I